Yes, yes, it's your boy, the world's famous DJ Hayes from the Universal Zulu Nation Air Force Crew.
Yes, yes, y'all, it's your boy, the world famous DJ Hayes with my man Faps on another P-Force banger. Let's go!
Let's get the party shaking, let's get the dance floor quaking. Show me what you got, girls get naked, let's get it crunk. Here we go.
I represent about six of the seven elements of hip-hop. I lock, pop, break, DJ, rap, I produce beats. I was started DJing when I was about 9-ish. I started, and I thought I was pretty good by the time I was 11, 12. I mean, I was already experimenting when I was younger, but then when I was like 11, 12, I was already actually like going out to parties. I was at this party, and he's like, hey, can you take over for me? I'm going to go to the bathroom. So I threw the next record, and basically that was it. I've done a lot of big things. For instance, I DJ about 5 times a year in Germany. I've performed for the Queen of England at the Queen's 50th Jubilee. The movement came out in 1992. We first came out at the Winter Music Conference.
Oh yeah, we about to make you jump. Only for the hardcore, strictly for the headstrong. Are you ready? 5, 4, 3. You know the rest.
Jump everybody, jump everybody, jump, 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 everybody, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump.
The song Jump. Well, actually, a couple of friends of mine kept coming to me all the time and like, oh, I heard you at the Lakers game. Oh, I heard you at the Lakers game. I'm like, what are you guys talking about? I wasn't at the Lakers game. So one of my friends, he's like, I'm going to take you to the game. I'm at the game. The game's about to start. And there goes my voice screaming, are you ready, from this record Jump that I made in 92. It's really a mystery how it happened. I mean, I don't know really how it happened. And for a while, I wasn't even receiving my royalties from that. And we actually had to take them to court and everything. And then we won a settlement. Now they pay me like a certain amount every season or something like that. So that's cool. But yeah, it's still a mystery. I don't know whose idea it was to use my voice at the Staples Center.